First and foremost, we like to give all praise and glory to Yahawah, Bahashem, Yahawashi, Bahashem, Bekakadash. Like a double monster apostles and elders of GMS. And salutations to your brother pushing truth, and sincerity. GMS, I'm Tashmore from GMS Mississippi Camp. And we'll do a quick lesson on prophecy. You know, that's our job, is to prophesy on what's going on or what's about to happen. That's our job. We're supposed to prophesy. We're supposed to let the people know, also let the other nation know what's about to happen, what's going to happen. And I'm going to start off with Revelation 19:10. And I fell at his feet to worship him. And he said unto me, seest thou to do it not, I am thy fellow servant, and of thy brother, that have the testimony of Yahawashi, worshiping the Most High. For the testimony of Yahawashi is the spirit of prophecy. So if you're not prophesizing, you don't have a testimony of Yahawashi. Other camps is not prophesizing. They're not telling the people what's about to happen. They're not. They all about money. More money come. That's what they happy about. I mean, what's going on in the world right now? That coronavirus is shutting everything down. The apostles and elders and brothers been talking about a pestilence coming. They been talking about this for the longest. And it's here now. And Lord willing, this is the pestilence that the main one that every brother been talking about. And the apostles been talking about. Lord willing, this be the prophecy, the pestilence. Because it shutting everything down. Nobody can come in. Trump just banned flights over from Europe over here. And you know, we talk about the earthquakes in diverse places. A lot of earthquakes going on. A world of people. Everything going on. That's in the book of Matthews. It said these things will come. I'm just gonna get it, though. This is Matthew 24. I'm gonna start at 6. And you should hear rumors of wars. You should hear of wars. And rumors of wars, see ye be not troubled, for all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet. Verse 7, for nation shall rise against nation, kingdom against kingdom, and there should be famines and pestilence and earthquakes in diverse places. Ain't a famine down in Venezuela? It's the pestilence right now, it's coronavirus. Like I said at the beginning, it shouldn't everything down, man. It shouldn't a lot of stuff down. The NBA ain't playing their games. They canceled the whole season. California shut off. New York shut off. This gonna be worldwide. Cause this person is not just in the United States. It's everywhere. They should try to control it. Keep it not spreading, but it still might spread regardless. Lord willing, it does. So, you know, I hope this be it. Cause all I know, the men, the brothers, the apostles, man, we ready to get up out of here. We ready to get out of this wicked kingdom we in and get in our kingdom so we can live right, righteous. All right, it's Habakkuk. I'm going to Habakkuk. Come on. of his habit, too. Slack. Damn it, man. Yeah, wrong with me. The habit of two and one. Started one. And I was standing upon my watch and set me upon the towers. And I was watching to see and what it said unto me. And what should I answer then? And what should I answer when I ask and when I'm approved? It's like verse 2. And the Most High answered me and said, write the vision and make it plain upon tables, that you may run and read it. Verse 3. For the vision is not yet for a point of time, but at the end shall speak and not lie. Though it tarry, wait for it, because it was sure to come. So the prophecy may not come when you want to come. It's going to come when Yahawashi says time. So it may tarry, but it's still going to come regardless. Prophets are coming to pass, and the people, the two-thirds, and elites, can't do nothing about it. It's coming. And the brothers truth, we wanted to come. Come, we ready to get the hell up out of here, man. It's been like, when I found out when they, last night we was at the brother Yash. We were watching the game. So we got done doing a lesson, a weekly lesson. And they said the NBA suspended the season. Man, first thing I got, that damn vodka the brother had for me. And I turned it up. That's some great joy, man. That's some news the brother been wanting to hear for a while. It lifted up my spirit, lifted up the brother's spirits, and all the brothers doing videos on this, man. It's a beautiful thing going on right now. Like the brother said, it's a happy time to be alive. What's going on now? It's a happy time to see. And you know, we want to see a downfall of enemies. We want to see two-thirds get put down. And we want to see the legs raise up. Start with apostles and elders of GMS. We want to see that. We tired of being down, man. Alright. I didn't see it on that one. I'm going to see what I got up. And this, you know, like I said, this is our job. This is our job to warn the people. To prophesy. This is Ezekiel 33:1. Again, the word of the Most High came to me. This is Ezekiel 33:1. Again, the word of the Most High came to me, saying, son of man, speaking to the children of thy people, and saying to them, I will bring a sword upon the land, and the people, and if the people of the land take a man of their coast, yeah, of the coast, and set him for their watchman, mean somebody out of your nation, and watch what was going on. And that's what the brother's doing right now. We watching. We doing what we need to do. Come on, all right. 3. If when he see the sword come upon the land, and he blow the trumpet and warn the people, and we know when you see something about to come, we supposed to warn the people, and that's what we've been doing. Verse 4. That whosoever hear the sound of the trumpet and take not warning, if the sword come and take him away, his blood should be upon his own head. So we telling you what's about to go down, and if you can't get it, if you don't take heed of it, and the sword come upon you and take you, and that's on you, cause we did our job. We blowing the trumpet. We trying to let you know. We sound the alarm. We prophesied what's about to happen. All right, verse 5. He should sound the trumpet. Verse 5. He heard the sound of the trumpet, and took not warning, and a blow shall be upon him, but he was taken warning shall but he that taketh warning shall be lit to deliver his soul. Verse 6. And this verse 6 could go to a lot of you fake pastors and you Israelite camps leaders. But if the watchman see the sword coming and blow not the trumpet, and the people be not warned, if the sword come and take any person from among them, he is taken away in his iniquity, but the blood will I require at thy watchman's hand. So the Most High gonna require your blood for you not warning the people. But you know, you gotta prophesy to the people, but you're not. You know, your other camp's not prophesying, telling people what's about to happen. World War III, famine, pestilence right now, martial law, race riots. Y'all not doing that. But the brothers at GMS and Apostle Store and the Apostle and Elders on down, we doing that. We warn the people. And we prophesize. And with that, I hope y'all edified. Love y'all. Praise the Lord to Yahawah, Bahashem, Yahawashi, Bahashem, Bekakadash, like a dumb unto the apostles and elders of GMS. And Sagittarius, brother, push the truth and sincerity. Shall one, it's real.